Face. It's just a reminder of who he is. Amen? Sometimes this world can sound so loud with its negativity, with its chaos, with its confusion. But our God is so much bigger than any of those things. Our God has done the impossible and will continue to do so. There is nothing too big. There is nothing too difficult. There is nothing beyond his reach. Father God, you've reminded us time and time again that we are in your hands. And right now, Lord, we ask you to forgive us, Father God, for any bit of doubt we have, Father God. Help our unbelief today in this place, Lord. Jesus, we just empty ourselves out before you, Father. You know our hearts, Lord. You know what's in there and what's not supposed to be right now, Father God. And we just ask that you would remove those things right now, those things that are holding us back, Father God, those things that are weighing us down, those things that are distracting us from looking toward you instead of looking to our problems, Father God. Keep our eyes on you, O Lord.
This is my surrender. Thank you. Let's just lift up our hands, one without doubt and one without wrath. Don't worry about the person that's next to you. Just get a hold of God. How many of you came to church not just to be in church, not to be in here, but to go ahead and just get a hold of God right now? Father God, we come before you right now, Lord Jesus. We ask you right now that you just remove every distraction, anything that is trying to hinder our hearts. Take away the stress, the heaviness, that we may lay down our yoke, that we may pick up your yoke, Father God, for your word says that your yoke is easy. And we just ask you right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father God, that when we're feeling down in the dump, you're right there to pick us right up and tell us it's okay, son. It's okay, daughter. Pick yourself back up and keep moving forward. Come on, church. Let's just get a hold of them right now. Father, we thank you right now, Father God, just for our pastors, Father God, Pastor Edgy and Pastor Sonia. We pray, Father God, that you may just protect them, Lord, wherever they may be right now, Father God, that you may camp your angels around them, around their children, around this ministry, Father God. We lift up every single ministry that is in this house, from the kids to the worship team to the ushers. We pray, Father God, for new people, Father God, to be able to help out to lift up the hands of our pastor, Father God. Yes, Lord, so we can go into battle and do what we need to do for you, God, that we will not be that we will not be cowards, but that we will go in like mighty men, mighty women in your house, Lord. We thank you so much. We pray for a fresh vision, a fresh anointing to reach, teach, and send, oh God. We give you everything right now. And can we please just extend our hands to the prayer wall right now? Heavenly Father, we come before you here tonight, oh God. We thank you, Father God, and we're just going to have the faith of a mustard seed that you've already touched every single person in that picture frame right now, Lord. We give you everything right now, Father God, and we know that you're making a way right now for those people, even for the people that are not on that wall, that we have in our hearts and in our minds, that you've already sent ministering angels to them, Father God, every way possible, because we serve a God of impossible. We thank you, and we give you all honor and all glory, and all the men and women say. Come on, church, let's just worship right now. Come on, all we need to do is just worship. Come on, sing it out, follow the words. Come on. Come on, how many of you love the Lord? Come on, sing it out to him right now. Sing it out. Let those shackles just fall right now. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on, church. How many of you know that God's way is a better way? Come on. How many of you know that he is our great defender? Amen. How many of you know that you have been saved by the blood of Jesus? Say Jesus. Hallelujah. Woo! How many of you ready to have some church here tonight? Amen. As you make your way back to your seats, you can go ahead and have a seat as we get ready for tonight's announcements. Amen.
We're so glad you came to worship with us today. On behalf of Pastors Edgy and Sonia Gallegos, welcome to Living Word Inland Empire. For all our LW parents, we are so excited to announce our new VBS theme in our Sunday school for kids ages 4 through 11 called You Are His Treasure. It'll be taking sale this Sunday at 11 a.m. We can't wait to see them all there.
Get excited, Living Word. Conference is just a few weeks away. Join us as Pastors Edgy and Sonia, alongside with Living Word San Gabriel Valley, host the Stay in the Course Conference in Modesto, California. If you are unable to join us there, we encourage you to join in at one of our other locations in Pasadena and in Bakersfield. We can't wait for you to join us. Also, if you are planning on joining us in Modesto and haven't booked a room yet, you can call the Holiday Inn Express and Suites off of Bangs Avenue in Modesto to check out the rooms they have available.
Is this your first time joining us? If so, we would love for you to text NEW to LW to the number 844-520-0062 so we can connect with you and we can keep you updated with everything going on here at Living Word. Would you like to stay connected with us on all our social media platforms for all our upcoming events? You can do so by subscribing to our YouTube channel, liking our Facebook page, and following our Instagram.
If you happen to miss a service, don't worry, we have you covered. You can check us out on podcasts by searching Living Word of IE. God bless and enjoy. All right, church, it's time for tithes and offerings. So let's open our hearts and get ready to give.
Excuse me. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a good clap offering today. Amen. Amen. As ushers come forward, if you need an envelope, just lift up your hands. How many guys decided to be in the house of the Lord today? Amen. Amen. As we turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 9, 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7. Amen. How many guys are going to be ready for conference? Amen. How many guys excited for conference? Amen. It's fun because we get to go to a different city and spread the good news out there. Amen. It's fun to go out there, meet new brothers and sisters in the Lord, and get them on fire. Amen. Amen. As we pick up today's tithes and offerings, it says right here in verse 7, each one must do just as is purposed in his heart. Amen. Not grudgingly or under compulsion, for God loves what? A cheerful giver. Amen. And I love how when God gives us something, he always gives us what he promises after. He tells us what to do, and then he tells us what's going to go on after. He says right here, as God is able to make all grace abundant to you, so that you always have sufficient in everything. He doesn't say just give because I want your money. He doesn't say give because I need your money. He says give because I asked you to give. Amen? How many sometimes as a parent you just say, do what I told you to do. I'll reward you later. Amen? If you just do what I told you to do. And he's telling us right here that his rewards is that we'll never have to be thirsty. We'll never have to be hungry. We'll never have to ask. We'll never have to beg on the street. Why? Because he is sufficient for us. Our life isn't our life. Our life is his life. Amen? So when we put our heart into him, he puts his heart into us. It's only up to us. He doesn't want your money. He wants your heart. He doesn't need your $5. He don't need your $10. He don't need your $50,000. Amen. It would be a good tithing, but he's looking for your heart. Why? Because he said to the lady with the three mites, she gave with all her heart. She gave more than everybody out there. She gave more than the rich because that was everything she had. That's why when God gives, he goes, I'm looking at your heart. I just want to know that you're with me. I just want to know that you're there for me. I just know I could call upon you when I need something here on earth. Amen. As a vessel. Amen. Not as a savior, but as a vessel. Amen. So as we give, remember that we don't have to give at a grudgingly. We don't have to give because Brother Manuel said I have to give. I don't want you to give because I told you to give. I want you to have a relationship with God so he could bless you abundantly. You could partake in that because my clap offering ain't going to get you nowhere. Amen? Because you're not going to like my clap offering. Amen? If you show me how much you gave. But God looks at your heart. And he says, they did what I asked them to do. They did what I called them to do. Amen? They did it. They did it. So as we pick up today's tithes and offerings, not out of grudgingness, not out of necessity, just because we love God. We don't do things because he's on our to-do list. Amen? We do it because we love him. We do them because we want to, not because we have to. Father God, we just thank you today. And we just want to show you that we love you in all aspects, Lord. We're here to worship you. We're here to give to you. We're here to cry out to you. We're here to lift you up, Father. As we just thank you today, because you are an awesome God. You are the fathers of everybody. You are the creator of the earth, Father. And we know that. And we bow down to you and only you as we give to you with our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a good clap offering. Offering as he comes, give the word today. Amen. Come on, let's give him a good clap offering today. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. One step at a time.
Praise the Lord. Amen. I got to take one step at a time. I can't run like I used to. Praise the Lord. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. You may be seated. Praise God. I want to just thank Pastor Edgy and Sonia and this congregation for blessing me and my wife. Amen. And welcoming us in this fellowship. Amen. In this church. Amen. I thank God. Amen. It's a privilege to preach the gospel. Amen. Especially when you've been doing it all your life. Amen. God is molding and shaping me. Amen. I'm in the right place. Hallelujah. I thank God for Pastor Edgy. I thank God for the men's home. The worship team's awesome. Amen. Give the Lord a clap offering because God is in this place. Amen. Praise God. As I find my message, staying on course. Amen. Hallelujah. I pray that you go to conference. Amen. It's going to be powerful. Amen. I'll tell you what, if you're going to stay the course, you're going to have to strive. You're going to have to work hard. You're going to have to labor, amen, because staying on course, amen. I'll tell you what, you need to take advice, amen. That's the title of my message. Can you take advice? Hallelujah. I came to my pastor. I asked Pastor Edgy a few times, what should I do about this situation? And he told me, but he said, it's up to you. Hallelujah. How many know we're going to, I don't know about you, but I'm a fool, amen. I do whatever I want, amen. But I'll tell you what, God's hands upon me and you, amen. We need to listen to our pastor, them that are in our authority, amen. Because the Bible says they watch over your soul, amen. They're praying for you and I. I'll tell you what, tonight, God wants to speak to you and I. Can you take advice? Samuel, 1 Samuel 25, verse 32 and 33. 1 Samuel 25, 32 and 33. Hallelujah. And David said to Abigail, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who sent you this day to meet me. Verse 33. Blessed be your discretion, and blessed be you who have kept me this day from bloodshed and from working salvation with my own hands. Let's pray. Precious Father, Lord, I pray that you'll help me tonight to deliver this message to your people. And I pray that you'll touch every individual and that you'll encourage them and that you'll bless them and you'll move in their life. And I also pray for my pastor and his wife and his family that you'll continue to have your hand and your hedge of protection around them. I thank you, Lord, for this congregation and the men's home and the women's home, that you'll continue to bless them and they grow in you. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, amen. Can you take advice? That's a question. How many know many times people tell us what to do? We ask them, but we don't do it. I guess it's just me. You see, the mark of success for a person is he or she has the ability to take advice. See, if you're going to do something great in the kingdom of God, you're going to have to learn, amen, to take advice from your pastor, your leaders, them that are in authority over you. And I'll tell you what, you'll go a long way. You see, an open mind is a good companion with an open heart. Where's your mind tonight? The Bible says that you and I, we need to have the mind of Christ. Is your heart open this evening to the things of God? Or are you just spinning your wheels? You see, there are pathetic examples in the Bible. Hallelujah. Some of the people in the Bible are recorded. Wouldn't take advice. How many know that sometimes I don't want to take no advice? You know, I'm from Boyle Heights. You know, so I've got to take no from nobody. Take advice. I'll give you advice, homegirl. Hey, homie, I'll tell you what to do. How many know we don't like, we bring the world mentality into the church. You see, the Lord will break you down. How do you know? I'm the perfect example right here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Number one, they couldn't take advice, was Balaam. Number two was Saul. Number three was Pilate. And number four was Ahab. That's just to name a few. Do you know anybody like that? Huh? That bumped their head because they didn't want to take advice. You need to stay in the home a little bit longer, brother. Oh, man, stick it in your ear, man. I got to do what I got to do. That's why you're back again. Hallelujah. Don't shout me down, but hallelujah. Balaam, I just wrote a few. I didn't want to write them all, but Balaam was motivated by greed and by a desire for wealth. How many know sometimes we get greedy? We get greedy. And God says, I don't want you to be greedy. I want you to be a giver. Amen. Todo para acá. We're like the restrio, like a rake. Rake it all right here, baby. Rake it all right here. What are you motivated by? You see, the love, the wages of unrighteousness. He loved, Balaam, he loved unrighteousness. How many know sometimes we can love unrighteousness? Number two, Saul. King Saul. The Lord had touched his life. The Lord had gave him specific instructions. King Saul made excuses and even blamed others. How many know many times we make excuses? Oh, you know what? It was a brother's. It's the pastor's fault. It's the pastor's wife. It's the leader's fault. I'll tell you what. We got to stop making excuses. The buck stops right here. Hallelujah. It's me. Hallelujah. I blew it. Hallelujah. Blame our wife. Always blaming the wife. Marrate, homie. Tie your belt. Blame everybody else but ourselves. It's me, hallelujah. I'm the one that's jacked up. I need Jesus. Making excuses. The Lord told him, destroy, destroy the Amalekites. Everything, todo, all of it, destroy them. How many know there's things in your life, in my life, that we need to destroy? Because I'll tell you what, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. God says, I want you to clean house. We don't want a clean house. You remember when I first got saved, I had a couple of phone numbers for some of the homegirls. Just in case Jesus didn't work, I could call one of the homegirls up. Because, you know, I'm a smooth operator. My name is Paul, Larry. My name is Rudy. I like all the women of the world. Can somebody say Jesus? He said destroy everything. We could have a stash. I remember I had my stash under the rock outside the house so my wife wouldn't find it. How many know that people know? You could fool everybody else. I remember when I used to come home and I'd come home late. I'd put grease on, because I'm a mechanic. I'd put grease on me. And she said, what have you been? I just had to work overtime, honey. Just work it overtime. I was only fooling myself. She'd look right through me. Her eyes were like Jesus. His eyes pierce. Boom. Hallelujah. Saul had become very proud of himself. How many know sometimes we're proud? We're proud. Even when you stand proud. Give me one of these seeds. What are you going to tell me? You ain't got nothing to say to me. I've had churches, amen, and people are like, man, what's that little short guy going to tell me? He doesn't know nothing, that little short guy with a ball on his nose. They used to talk about me. But I tell him, you know what, man? I'm telling you for your own good. You better be careful. We look at our pastor, and he tells us something, or his wife, and we say, give me out of this seat. We need to humble ourselves. Can somebody say Jesus? Jesus. He kept the Amalekite king alive. He should have killed the king, that devil, hallelujah. As well as the best of everything. How many know that sometimes we want to keep some stuff? Huh? Hallelujah. I remember when I used to sell candy, I wouldn't want to keep some of the candy for myself, some of the money too, hallelujah. Why you look at me like that? I'm straight from the hood, you know. I got hood in me. And the Lord says, give it all up, Rudy. You got to give it all up. So what they used to do to me, empty your pockets, hallelujah, and strip down, homie. Hallelujah. You'll get it later. See, David had been insulted by a man named Nabal. His name meant fool. And in Spanish, I wouldn't want to say it, but I'll tell you what, just think about it. Imagine your name being Nabal, fool, sister, hallelujah. How many know that the devil will play you for a fool? How many know we think we're getting over, but we're not giving over? Hallelujah. You see, the man was mean, asking for trouble and unreasonable. Have you ever met anybody like that that's just mean, just a mean old person? I remember I used to be like that. Hallelujah. Mean as can be. Amen. Mean as can be. I remember pastoring in Palm Springs. Amen. Mean as can be. The Lord sent me all the way to Chile. He says, I'm going to break you down, fool. He says, because you're mean. Hallelujah. Mean, just mean. And I love trouble. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Bring it on. Bring it in. Bring it up. I love trouble. Unreasonable. How many know there's some people you can't even reason with them? You talk to them. Oh, my kid's in Sunday school. Hey, what did you tell my kid, man? What did you tell him? The parents come up. I didn't tell him nothing. Hallelujah. What did you tell my wife? Unreasonable. The Bible says, God says, can I reason with you? Can I talk to you? Can we reason together? You know, sometimes people get out of hand. Not me, Pastor. Yeah, you just got out of hand just the other day. Chequeate. Check yourself. Samuel 25, 10 and 11. Samuel 25, 10 and 11. Can you take advice? Even your wife will tell you, hey, you know what? My wife told me a lot of things, but I still got in trouble because I was unreasonable. I didn't care. She told me, don't do that. Don't say that. I said, anyway. Hallelujah. And Nabal answered David's servants. Who is David? Who is the son of Jesse? Is there many servants these days who are breaking away from their masters? Shall I take my bread and my water and my meat that I have killed for my shears and give it to men who come from I do not know? Where I do not know? Imagine this. Here's a man of God. He was protecting his sheep, protecting his men from getting their sheep stolen. And he tells David like that. He insults. How many ever been insulted? Have you ever been insulted? You come to church, oh, he insulted me. I'm not coming back no more. Sometimes you just got to eat it up. Hallelujah. See, the church is for unsaved people. People got to be crazy, you know. Yeah. Dealing with people is hard. No? You try to be kind to them and they're telling you off and you just say, man, this guy's insulting me. And the Lord tells you, don't say nothing, Chacon. Don't say nothing. I don't want to say something. Then I start shaking. How many know what I'm talking about? No? You've never been in the market and they just cut in line? You've been in a Disneyland or Knoxville and they just cut in line. People are cutting in line and the family, and then your line starts moving back and you want to see something, but you got the church right there, living word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Insulted. How many we're going to get insulted? People are going to tell us things. You see, David was determined to give Nabal a beating and teach him a lesson. How many know something? You know what, man? I'm just going to give him. You know what, Brother Bobby? I'm going to teach this a lesson. And then the Lord says, you don't touch my anointed. David got mad. How many know sometimes we can be hot-headed? No, just me, I guess. I was telling the men and women something the other day. A lady just, I was in McDonald's. I was just trying to get my coffee, you know, just trying to get a little bit of coffee just before I go preach. And the lady just cut in front of me. I said, oh, man. I felt like telling, hey, homegirl, what's up with you? The Lord told me, just shut up, just shut up. Hallelujah. Just teach him a lesson. How many know that God wants to teach you and I a lesson? That's why I sit right there. God, I'm teaching you a lesson. Teach you a lesson. All right, God, I'm going to take your advice. Yeah, after 45 years, you're finally taking advice from me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. You see, I wonder, how could a mean knucklehead, a stupid person like Nabal, could have married such a common sense virtuous, cool-headed woman like Abigail. Man, she was pretty. She was fine. Oh, man, her lips, if she wore that lipstick, I mean, it'll break the ground on a hot day. She was beautiful. But I wonder, why did she marry this knucklehead? Hallelujah. Maybe she married the rancher to change him. How many know that you can't change nobody? My first wife, my second wife, nobody can change me. It takes the power of God to change your life. I'll tell you what, it's the blood of Jesus. It's the anointing of God. It's the word of God that'll change your life. You got to want to, amen. Your heart's got to be open. God will change your marriage. He'll change your kids. But you got to be a man of prayer and understand the word of God. That can always be a disappointment of disappointments. If they haven't changed, they won't change after they sign the marriage certificate. Wow, it's quiet in here. Before you get married, make sure that she prays. She's a woman of God. He's a man of God. Because after they sign on the dotted line. You're in trouble. You'd be like Gomer Pyle, golly. Shazam, you know. Yeah, Shazam it'll be too. Abigail learned the hard way. How many know that many times we got to learn things the hard way? You see, it's either God's way, or I'll tell you what, it's the highway. I'll tell you what, if God is not in it, I'll tell you what, you shouldn't do it. You should obey God rather than man. Obey the word of God. The word of God has good advice. You need to pick it up. You need to read the word of God. I'll tell you what, if you read the word of God, you won't get in trouble. Hallelujah. You'll do what God has in this book. Hallelujah. Can you take advice? Many times women have to cover their husband again and again and again and again. Cover up their husband. Pastor Edgy calls, hey, let me talk to Flaco. Well, he's in the restroom. Well, he went to the restaurant. You cover for him. Hallelujah. Or you cover for your wife. Women are crazy too. Women are crazy. How do I know? I married one of them. Hallelujah. And you can cover for them and cover for them, but God sees them. You see, Abigail tells David that his anger with her husband is justifiable, but you're a man that God has ordained. He was mad. He was mad because they disrespected him. He got 400 men, amen, together. He said, we're going to go take care of business. I know about that, amen. I was in the neighborhood. Well, they did this. We're going to take care of business. Hothead. Go to jail, too. In other words, think about what you're going to do. How many know that sometimes we got to think about what we're going to do, but we don't think, amen. I don't know about you, but I'm a person that don't think, I act. I just do it. I don't care who's looking. I don't care what's going to, I don't care the concept. I just do it. You don't know nobody like that? You need to think. Okay, if I do that, what's going to happen here? If I do this and I go there, what's going to happen? What's the outcome? Can you take advice? Don't do that. Here's Abigail, a woman of God. David, it's justifiable that you want to beat my husband, teach him a lesson, but don't do it. You're a man of God. You're ordained. Don't do it. Hallelujah. See, Abigail draws a picture of the days that are ahead to come when all the enemies who stand against David will be overthrown. See, she paints a picture of his life. He says, if you do that now, way back up there in front, you know, God's going to get your enemies and he's going to destroy your enemies. But if you do this, you're going to look back. And God said, you know what? You did this wrong right here. Don't do it. She paints a good picture. How many know that the circumstances are there before you? How many, you never made a mistake? And you go, man, I got to start all over again? David, don't be an instrument of vengeance. How many know that we're either an instrument of God, God's weapon, God could use you as a weapon, or we're an instrument of vengeance. Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. But how many know that we want to take things into our own hands sometimes? No, just me, I guess. Just all by myself. No wonder I got this message. I'm preaching to myself. I'm going to get saved. Calm down. Have they ever told you, Calmale, calm down, calm down, Rudy, calm down. Everything's going to be all right. And you're just a hothead. No, you're smoking. Oh, no. Don't even hold me back. No? I'm going to tell Pastor Edgy, I'm going to tell Sonia, I'm going to tell the lead, I'm going to tell that usher. Calm down. Abigail gave David good advice. How many know that people want to give you and I good advice? But it's up to you and I to take that advice and say, I'm going to take it with a grain of salt. I'm going to know that's from God. And I'm going to humble myself. And I'm not going to take vengeance. I'm not going to be a hothead. I'm going to calm down. It is not always easy for a man to take advice from a woman. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Man, I'm going to take advice from you? Tell my wife, huh? You mean I gotta listen to you? How many know that's why God gave you a wife? And if you're not married here, you need to get married. That's good advice. David listened. David listened. Are you listening? Are you listening to what God is saying to you and I? David listened. And said, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, who sent you this day to meet me, and let your advice be blessed. How many know that God will always show up? God will always show up. Just like when I was in the line at McDonald's. This is just one incident. There's many incidents every day in my life. God shows up, shut up. Guy at this, zip it up, fool. Be quiet, button it up. How many know the mouth gets you in trouble quick? No? In the world, I always got my mouth busted up. You got a big mouth. It's a, well, bust it up, homie. Run up. How many know the devil busted up too? Can you take advice? You see, Solomon was given wisdom, yet he says in Proverbs 13:10, this is Solomon, a wise man of God. How many know that you and I could be wise also? You're a woman of God. You could be wise. If you study the scriptures, you study the word, amen, the word of God will flow out of your heart, amen. You see, pride leads to conflict. Those who take advice are wise. You'll always be in conflict. Always. Always. You get married, conflict. You have kids, conflict with the kids. You go to church, conflict. You go to work, conflict. Why? Because that's what the Bible says. But those who take advice are wise. If you take the word of God, God will speak to you. He will literally tell you you're going the wrong way. God has not left humanity without good advice. Ephesians 4:11. How many are there with me? Ephesians 4:11. And he gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the shepherds and teachers to equip the saints for the work of the ministry, for building up the body of Christ until we are all obtained in the unity of the faith and in the knowledge of God, of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to measure of the statures of the fullness of Christ. He gave us pastors. He gave us teachers. He gave them in charge to us so they can help us and give us good advice and direct us. How many know as a father, I'm a father, I have two daughters and my son, I would direct them, I would help them, I would show them the right way. That's why I got saved. I go, you know, my kids ain't going to be gang members. My daughters ain't going to be on the streets. Amen. I'm going to help them. I'm going to serve God. I'm going to be a man of God. My wife's going to be a woman of God. And God's going to give me common sense. And today they're in church. My grandkids are in church. They're preachers. Hallelujah. You see, the final goal is maturity. Are you maturing in God? Are you growing up in God? You grow old, you can grow old, but can you grow up? They have told me time and time, Rudy, you look old, but have you grown up? Have you matured? The final goal is the truth, and the truth will set you free, and you shall know. You got to know the truth. And how about love? In the world, we're haters. If you're from my hood, you ain't nothing. We come to Christianity and we start hating still. How many know the love of God will cover a multitude of sins? I said the love of God, amen, will cover a multitude of sin. I'll tell you what, where sin abound, grace abound more. God is moving in your life. You got to keep on going. That's good advice. Hallelujah. David testified in Psalms 73, verse 24. You will guide me with your counsel and afterwards receive me to glory. How many know that God is going to guide you? I'll tell you what, there's heaven, friend. That's what he talks about, glory, amen. We're heaven bound, amen. This is not your home, amen. You can store up all the stuff up, but I'll tell you what, I'm heaven bound. I want to take souls with me, amen. I don't want to go, but I'm going to preach the gospel. Can somebody say Jesus? He wants to help you, God. He wants to help you and me. He wants to keep you from going off the deep end. How many know that we could go off the deep end? I'm a person shot. I go off to the deep end. Help me, Jesus. Ephesians 4, 14 and 15. I'm almost done. Hallelujah. 14. so that we may no longer be children about by every wind of doctrine, by human cunning, by craftiness in deceit schemes, rather speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in every way into the Him who is the head, unto Christ. How many know it? You can't go for anything. You read your Bible, you got to read it yourself. I read it myself. I got saved. I said, I got to learn how to read. I learned how to read and I read the Bible. I'm not going to go where anybody tells me. I want to know. I want to know where I'm going. In the world, I wanted to know. I was a driver. I wanted to know where I was going. I knew how to take the 50 bus, the number 9, the 100 bus, and what. I knew where I was going. And when I changed partners, I stopped dancing with the devil, and I started dancing with Jesus. I said, I got to know where I'm going. I'm not going to be in the blind of La Rava. I can't see. No. I know where I'm going. I'm heaven bound. Abigail helped David not to make a mistake that would haunt him the rest of his life. She helped him. How many know that we're here to help you? We're here to help you. Pastor Edgy, Sonia, the leaders in this church, they're here to help you and guide you. So it's very important that you learn how to pray. Talk to the Lord. Lord, I'm a fool. I'm messed up. You got to help me. And the Lord says, I'm going to help you. Now open up the Bible. Hallelujah. Open up my word. You should begin to read the word, and God begins to help you. Begins to move in your life. And you begin to grow, and you begin to mature, and your life begins to change. One day, you must look back. One day, you're going to look back. I mean, all the way back. Will you be filled with regret or thanksgiving? One day, you're going to have to look back. I got to look. I look back every day, all the way back when I was 20 years old. Man, God, help me, Lord. You're going to have to look back. I messed up over here. What did I do over here? Did I hurt that person? You're going to have to look back. See, you're going to have to get an account to your life when you stand before God. There's going to be an audit. I mean, nobody likes to get an audit. You know, the RAS, we're going to audit you. Well, there's going to be an audit, and you stand before God. I believe that's good advice. I pray you may act upon it at this altar. God loves you with an everlasting love. Maybe you're not saved. You're not a Christian. Maybe you're a backslider. But the Bible says that God is calling you. God is calling you. He brought you this day because He wants to save you, wants to touch your life, wants to change your life. He wants to give you some good advice. He says, follow me, and I will make you a fisher of men. Follow me, and I'll show you eternal life. See, church, there's a real hell, and there's a real heaven. My wife died, and she was 13 years old. She went to hell. And God says, she never heard the gospel. Told Satan, let her go. She never heard of me. My wife took I don't know how many pills, but the Lord brought her back. Hell's real, but it is made for you and I. It was made for them, angels that got kicked out of heaven. But I'll tell you what, we got to be obedient to Christ. See, God's going to hold you and I accountable for what you know. He loves you. He cares about you. Make a choice. Serve God. Go all the way. You'll be blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I've been doing this since I was 20 years old. I'm blessed. I'm coming towards my end. Hallelujah. But I'm going to finish good. I'm going to finish strong. Hallelujah. God has great things for you. He got great things for me. This church is a powerful church. Powerful church. Let's stand in the presence of God. Presence of the Lord. God's here. You know, when I come to church, when I started coming here with Pastor Edgy and Sonia, when I come and I stand, I go, you know what, God? I don't want to lose my fire. I want to be fired up. I come to worship you. I come to praise you. And I don't care who's looking. I'm going to praise you. I'm going to worship you. Devil, you're a liar. I'm going forward. You need to come to this church with that kind of attitude. I come to get my praise on. And when Pastor Edgy begins to preach, excellent speaker. Excellent. I know him since he was young, 17, 18. And to see him preach and see this and see all you, I know that's God. Because he was a nobody that believed in somebody, and his name is Jesus. And just like he did it for him, he'll do it for you. God will do it again. God will do anything, but he will not fail. I see Art. Art was a knucklehead. Art was bad. He got on my nerves. He's a gangster. I was like Nabal. But I prayed for that man. He's a pastor today. Hallelujah. God is moving. God is moving. He gets all the glory. He gets all the praise. He gets all the honor because he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. If you're here today and you don't know Jesus, if you don't know Jesus, I'll pray with you. I'll lead you to the Lord. If you come up to here, to the altar. This is the altar where we all have to come. I remember when I got saved, I had to go to the altar. Hallelujah. Anybody need Jesus? Anybody need never confess Jesus? Is there any backsliders? You left God. You forgot about God. God brought you to church today. You need to give your life to God. Come on. Hallelujah. I'll pray with you. Praise the Lord. Everybody saved. Thank God. Give the Lord a clap offering. If the Lord spoke to you, you need prayer, just come to the altar. Amen. The altar is open. God will touch you. God will fill you. God will move in your life. God is a good God. Praise you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Let God move, friend. Your marriage, you don't have to say nothing, but you know that God spoke to you. How have you been acting with your wife or your husband? How about your children? God wants to mend. That's what we do here. God mends. Hallelujah. God help. He's a helper. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Precious Father, Lord, I pray for my brother right here. I pray as he's a leader, God, I pray that he'll be a good leader. He'll take good advice. Move in his life. Bless him. Bless him 100-fold. I pray for all the men's home. I pray for all the men's home. That, Father God, let them know that they're in your care. They're in your arms. I pray nothing but blessings shall follow them the rest of their life. And I pray, Father God, they honor you with their life. And devil, you're a liar. Take your hands off of every man is in the men's home. The blood of Jesus covers them. I pray in the name of Jesus, Hata la rama kaya la rama shinde, that the blood of Jesus will touch you, make you whole, bless your life, that you're a man that people look up to, a man of God, a man like David after God's own heart. Devil, you're a liar. Take your hands off of God's property. God's called you, brother. He's ordained your steps, and you're blessed. Hallelujah. You're blessed. Wherever your feet go, hallelujah. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus sets you free. My sister, hallelujah, the anointing of God is upon you. The anointing will break every yoke of bondage. The anointing of God will fill you up. I'll tell you what, lift up your cup to the Lord and he'll fill it. He'll fill it with joy, hallelujah, unspeakable and full of glory, hallelujah. He'll receive everything that God has for you. Receive it by faith. Receive it. I pray for you, brother Daniel, and your daughter. I pray that God's hand will continue to be upon you. You excite me. You got fire, hallelujah. You got Holy Ghost fire. I'll tell you what, God has something great for you. Hallelujah. Be a good listener. Take good advice from your pastor. Keep going forward. God will bless you and your family more and more and more, because that's what God wants to do. I pray for you, hallelujah. Pastor Ernie, I pray that God's hand continue to be upon you. And your dad, he's in heaven walking the streets of gold. Don't worry about nothing. You see, God takes care of the lily in the field where there's no water, there's no fertilizer. But God will take care of you, my brother. Worship him. Give him glory. Give him honor. Hallelujah. God is the God of breakthrough. God will break every chain, every chain, every chain. Hallelujah. Come on up here. Come on over here. Both of you, come on. Hallelujah. Harama Shinde. Hila Rama Kaya La Rama Mama Mama Rama. Is this your daughter? This your daughter? That's your mom? You love your mom? Hug your mom. Hug your mom like that. Hug your mom. Precious Father, I pray a double portion of the Holy Spirit. I pray for the mother and daughter. I pray, Father God, for their relationship. I pray that you continue to bless them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Be blessed. Hallelujah. Worship God. Hila Rama Shanda La Rama Kaya. Hila Rama Shanda La Rama Kaya. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. I pray that God will touch you right now. I pray that the glory of God will move in your life. The glory, the glory, the glory, the glory. Receive the glory of God. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Keep going forward. Keep going forward. Don't stop. Keep going. Keep going. Do not stop. I pray for all the women's home. I pray that God will touch you. I pray that God will bless you. Keep going forward. Do not stop. Keep going for God. Sisters, do not give up. Sisters, do not give up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praising you, giving you all the glory, giving you all the praise, thanking you, Jesus, thanking you, Jesus.
Just lift up your hands. Just extend them out to those that are still praying.
Amen. We had an awesome service. Lives were touched. Hearts were changed. I'm telling you, God is on the move, church. And we're grateful for you plugging in and staying connected with us. We know what we have a lot of different avenues where you can watch us on. You can watch us on Facebook. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can watch us on Instagram and allow God to minister you and keep you connected on what we're doing next and on what's taking place and what's going on here at Living Word. And so we're excited because we're seeing God move and we're seeing God just touch lives and God just doing miraculous things. And with your love and with your support and with you just allowing yourself to connect here, God wants to use you to make a difference and make a difference in your family, in your job, in your workplace. The message that God has spoken to you, the message that you've heard, is going to help you and build you to become that man of God and that woman of God you were called to be. Maybe you're saying, Pastor, well, I didn't have that chance to say that prayer. I was too embarrassed, or I was struggling to let go of some stuff, but I'm ready now. And so if you're ready now and you're ready to give your heart to God, I want you to say this simple prayer with me. Say, Jesus, forgive me of all my sins. Come into my heart and make me new. Thank you for forgiving me of all my sins. In Jesus' name, amen. That simple prayer has saved you, delivered you, set you free from your past, from the guilt, from the shame. And I'm telling you, now it's our job to stay plugged in, get involved, read your Bible, and stay away from the things of evil that get you caught up. I'm telling you, great futures ahead of you. Great purpose are ahead of you. And we want to be part of that. Maybe you want to comment or leave us a message or send us a information. We want to help you on your journey, on your new journey with the Lord. And so we're grateful for you. We love you here at Living Word. And we are grateful for you guys. Also, we want you to know we have rehab centers for men and women. Those who need help or those that are just tired and going through stuff and maybe you need just a little bit more than that, come to our centers. God will help you. God will do great things in you. Great men and women have come out of that. And I'm telling you, I came out of that center. God changed my life 28 years ago and I haven't been the same. And we want to do the same for families and friends out there who don't know God and want to know who God is. So we're excited. Come connect with us. Know what's going on. See what's going on here at Living Word. We love you. God bless you. And remember, with God, all things are possible.
We were so blessed to have you join us today at Living Word Inland Empire. If you would like to hear more of today's message, head on over to our podcast and search Living Word IE. We want to thank you for joining us. And if you would like to watch more sermons, be sure to follow us on Facebook and YouTube. Again, thank you so much for joining us. And we can't wait to see you for our next service.